Yo. Okay, look, before we even start the video, and I know you see the chat, that's the offline chat. Shout out to the offline chat, man. Before we get into it, I mean, you see what's on the screen. I'm Dante, giveaway for the YouTubes. Gotta put my ring on. Look. First thing I gotta tell y'all, okay, is that this is a limited edition. Like, once these sell out, and I know y'all were asking me this before, once these sell out, they will not be made again. So, like, if you miss out on the drop, you can't get it again. So, if you don't want to miss out on, you know, getting a little me, go ahead and sign up, bro. There's a link in the description, okay? You don't even got to click the little folder to open it up. Just click it, click the link, and you can, here, let me try it. Because I have zero entries here. How do I, so I'll just do YouTube. Visit on YouTube. And boom, bro. Ah, and then they need full name and email. I guess I need to be logged into, I guess, one of these in order to do it. I would do it from my phone, but, I mean, it's easier to show you guys from here. What happens if I was chosen? I mean, boom, I did it. There. But the release date for it is the 26th at 12 p.m. Or 3 p.m. Eastern time. That's my time. 3 p.m. Eastern time for me. 12 p.m. Pacific time. So, yeah, man. You heard what I said. So, you know, either do it or don't, man. Mother. Like this. This dropped. Did this came out yesterday? Or this something was just uploaded like a few hours ago. But from memes from Dante. But this is, I think this was from either earlier today or yesterday. Memes from Dante, Weird, Creepy, and Scary Volume 7, which means you already know, is to do with this fucking mic talking into his fucking, you know.
Feel like Pharrell in 07 on my shoes, ice cream, make stars, stop him out, it's a man down. What? Baby Milo custom PC getting fanned out. Fuck. Not from the block, I'm from the H and we don't play around. Catch him at a red light with a Nerf gun, we gon' spray him down.
Ew, ain't this the nigga that eat worms, bruh? It's crazy that we was just watching the wrestling shit, and now this weird-ass nigga pops up. This nigga was disgusting.
And I'm coming to get you.
Feels good to watch this and the sun's still out. Hell yeah. It's gonna be a fucking doll or something. Send that shit right back, bro. Throw that shit in the trash. Like the neighbor's trash. It's gonna be loud. There's gonna be something loud in my ear and I don't got fucking time for it because I already banged my head against my chair 4 times, bro. My head is a little...
Mercufa, it's 1 a.m. where I'm from. Please hold my hand tight.
It's gonna already be in the room, huh?
On this program, Mickey and I will...
Okay, that was creepy. That was creepy.
Introduce you to some Disneyland's newest and most exciting attractions.
It wasn't loud. They didn't need to, like, freaking, he didn't need to drop something, and it just made a sharp, daggering pain in your ear. It was just, the whole vibe was just creepy. Succeeded. Job done.
The Fabulous Pirates of the Caribbean.
Almost everyone has heard of the Pirates of the Caribbean ride at Disney World. But did you know that it was actually built before the movies came out? The ride's construction began in 1967 and was being overseen by Walt Disney himself. But the ride's creation was riddled in sinister details. While building the original set, the crew was struggling to create skeletons that looked real enough, so they decided to use actual human remains. And it's rumored that the human bones used are still on the ride today. This ride would also be one of the last projects Walt Disney would ever oversee, because he would die before it was finished, leading some of the crew to believe the ride was cursed.
Photos with disturbing backstories.
This is the last photo of Michael Rockefeller before he was consumed by a tribe. Hey, What the fuck was he doing out there? This car, this is the car of Robert Landsberg. He was a photographer that was unable to escape a He was a photographer that was unable to escape the volcanic eruption of the birth of the destruction.
This man learned that his grandmother's burial site was no longer being taken.
R.I.P. to that man, but I mean, bro, they throwing this fucking shit on the thing. Like, what the fuck? He was a photographer that was unable to escape the volcanic eruption with destruction that.
This man learned that his grandmother's burial site was no longer being taken care of. And you'll never guess what he decided to do about it. The YouTuber known as DJ Def Joey was heartbroken to find out that the cemetery his grandmother was buried in was wasting away and being neglected by the property manager. So he decided that the best course of
Bro, there was a cemetery that my grandma was buried in, and they were stacking bodies there. Like, what the fuck, bro?
Action that he could take would be to dig up his grandmother's grave himself, and then transport her coffin to his backyard. But this is when curiosity pushed him too far. According to Joey, the cost of relocating her to another cemetery would cost more than he could afford, so she became stuck in his backyard. That's when he decided to film this video to share his experience. But it's the end of this video that has left everyone who's viewed it absolutely shocked.
Okay, he doesn't show the body, does it? Like, does he? Like, he doesn't. You guys seen this? What happened? What'd he do?
Joey decided that he wanted to show the inside of the coffin.
Okay, hold on now. Hold on now. I can't be showing dead bodies on motherfucking Twitch.
And to his viewers. So he opened the coffin on camera.
Okay.
And then began kissing his grandmother's corpse on her mouth several times. Before closing the casket and informing the viewer that he has decided to keep her there in his backyard. The full uncensored video is titled My Dead Grandma's Coffin in My Own Backyard.
The note he read said, if you continue singing, you will die. Chat, sing along. Who the fuck would do that to him, bro? Wait, he actually got killed after? Oh, fuck the cartel. Oh, don't fuck with them niggas.
Tengo el alma enamorada no más de pensar el corazón de soñarme noche a noche dueño de tu amor. Tengo el alma enamorada muy en
That gotta be a movie. That gotta be a movie.
Enamorada mi bien, si me das toda tu vida, yo te la doy también.
And he's singing with some oomph too.
Enamorada no más de pensar el corazón de soñarme noche a noche dueño de tu amor. Tengo el alma enamorada, muy enamorada, mi bien. Si me das toda tu vida, yo te la doy también.
3 hours later, he was shot and killed by the cartel disguised as local police.
What blood curdling facts that you wish you never knew. Part 36. Babies bounce. Their bones are so soft that instead of thudding, they actually bounce a little. An Arizona man named Paul Menchaca was arrested after he faked having Down syndrome and hired female caregivers to bathe him and change his dirty diapers. Kids under 5 years old will often try to hide-
Wait, are these separate facts or like, he's just saying different, like what the fuck?
died from a fire instead of running, and firefighters find the bodies. Jacqueline Durand was hired to dog sit for a pit bull.
Yo, them prescriptions.
And German Shepherd and was told that they would be in their kennels. However, when she arrived, the dogs immediately attacked her, leaving her with over 800 bite marks and severe blood loss. If you want to sell your organs on the dark web, you'll get the most money for your small intestine, worth about $800,000.
Don't you need your small intestine? Like, what? How do people even know this shit?
This sketch shows the autopsy report of Kobe.
How you even sit down and, like, even make up a price for the fucking, for some insides?
Bryant after he died in a helicopter crash in 2020. If you look closely, you can see they noted a crown tattoo on Kobe's shoulder. Makes the whole thing a lot more real.
In 2008, Elizabeth Fritzl.
What? That was the stupidest shit ever. Like, what the fuck? This isn't a conspiracy. Like, we all know he fucking died. Like, he had tattoos. How the fuck is this? Bro, shut the fuck. Like, I feel like sometimes, just because people are celebrities, like, it's just like, people are more like, oh my God, like, oh my God, we see the tattoos. It's actually like this, this was real. Like, dude, of fucking course it was real. Like, why the fuck? I don't fucking know, man. Dude, Elizabeth, what happened? What happened?
Courage to tell the local police that she had been held captive for 24 years, trapped in the family cellar, abused daily, and even gave birth to 7 different children. Though sounding like a made-up story at first, it was found to be 100% true. In 1956, Joseph Fritzl married a woman named Rosemary. They had 3 sons and 4 daughters, including Elizabeth, who was born April of 1966. She lived a relatively normal life as a child, went through school like everyone else until 15 years old when she finished up, and decided she wanted to join a waitress course to start finally making money and to get away from her family. During this time, she ran away to move in with a friend. Sadly, the police found her and took her back home. In 1984, Joseph convinced his daughter Elizabeth to help him carry a new door into the basement, which ended up being the last piece to his carefully crafted dungeon. They went inside and secured the door, trapping them both in there. He knocked her unconscious and threw her into the chamber.
There was a movie based on this shit, like, or something like this.
He was the only one that knew this chamber even existed. In the coming weeks, her mother began to worry and ended up filing a missing persons report. Joseph forced Elizabeth to write a note stating she was okay and was living with a friend, but to not come looking for her. Joseph told his wife and the police that he was pretty sure she ran off to join a cult. For the next 24 years of Elizabeth's life, she was brought food and other supplies a few times a week to keep her alive in her new dungeon home. Elizabeth would go on to have 7 kids from her father's abuse, one dying shortly after birth. 3 of these kids, Joseph claimed they showed up at his doorstep. Child services came over and deemed them worthy of adopting these mystery children, who also didn't have to live in the basement.
Johnny Depp defamation of character sue on YouTube.
As children started to pile up, he was so kind as to enlarge her prison and even gave her a fridge and hot plates to cook with. In 2008, one of these children grew sick and wouldn't wake up. Elizabeth convinced Joseph to take the child to the hospital, where the police and the media started to grow suspicious of the mother's whereabouts. While that was going on, Elizabeth convinced Joseph to then take her to the hospital. The police separated them and promised Elizabeth if she told them everything, she would never have to see her father again. She told every detail. 9 days later, the kids were confirmed to be of Elizabeth and her father's creation. Joseph was found guilty of enslavement and false imprisonment, assault charges, and the murder.
Jesus Christ, bro.
Murder of the dead baby, closing the case on one of the most horrific modern-day multi-decade crimes.
Fire emergency.
Please don't talk to me. Listen. I'm sorry. I killed.
I remember this.
I've done this 40 times. Kimberly Compton.
I remember this story on this.
I don't know what's the matter with me. I'm sick. I'm gonna kill myself, I think.
Hold on, bro. What?
Counts of attempted.
You know what? I'll plead not guilty right now.
What, Lord of Thatcher?
I'll plead not guilty right now.
And your grant
was I would not allow myself to walk into even a potential trap.
I would not allow myself to walk into a trap.
Was you wanting to go anywhere?
Pull the body out onto the floorboards, put it on the sheet.
About a monster like me.
Why did you kill those people?
He got away.
Here's some unsettling facts about the loneliest place on Earth. Known as Point Nemo, or Latin for no one, it is the area in the ocean that is furthest from land on all sides. And despite being completely devoid of organic life, this is actually where the mysterious sound the bloop emerged from that scientists believed was a giant organic life form. And what I find most creepy is although it wasn't discovered till the 1990s, in 1928, H.P. Lovecraft said that this area was home to Cthulhu, one of the most disturbing creatures from his novels. If you happen to visit, which no one has yet, the closest people to you would be those in the International Space Station orbiting above.
Bloop, my nigga. Bloop. My top scary scenes. Yo, I thought she was riding dick, bro. I ain't gonna lie, what your creepy ass doing looking in windows anyway?
What the fuck?
Yo, hold on, that shit though, I don't know what the fuck I just saw, whatever that was. What the fuck? I'm dying right there. I'll probably jump too. The impact there, that gotta be better than whatever the fuck she was about to do to me. Yo, you see her run, like... Is that why is like this shit's so good, bro? That shit's so good. Was that like in theaters or anything like that? I feel like the movies that are like really good, that are really creepy, don't get like the type of attention that like are like the mainstream attention. I feel like it's the stuff that get jump scares and like that are loud noises and things like that. That's so fucking good. Replay it. Yo, it's just so good. Like just the anticipation, like seeing her running across the fucking... Holy shit. Just seeing her run and how it looks so weird, like, and not, like, even, like... See, that's why you gotta mind your business, bro. That's why you gotta mind your business. Sometimes you just gotta mind your own fucking business. Like, chat, just imagine. You see this and you know she's coming for you. Like, what the fuck? Just knowing she's coming for you, bruh. I don't know what's creepier. Her running up the stairs and hearing her shuffling running up the stairs, or what if she just started climbing up, like, the building? Like, started scaling the building towards you. And the way they did it, too, I thought they were going to have it the typical way where they bust in and the door breaks open. Yo, Alpha Squad, thank you so much for the 5 gift subs. That's what I thought was going to happen. But it's just, you just see the hands. You just see the hands peep through. Like, that's so much better than just a loud at, like, Jesus Christ, bruh. So fucking tall, bruh. Ugh. Now this scene here, this is a really, really fucking fire scene too, bro. This is the creepiest thing I've seen, like just the image. This dude's floating with a fucking cane. He has a cane and he's floating and it's just so creepy, bro. I remember when I first saw this, I was like, what the fuck is this? Look at this little nigga from, look like the little dude from Stuart Little, bro. Get your ass back in the bed, man. Look at this. Like, bro, what the fuck? Oh my God.
Hello? Haro? Hibachi Benihana Teriyaki.
Nagasaki, Okinawa, Hokkaido, Yokohama.
Karate Judo Sumo Samurai.
Nissan, Honda, Mitsubishi, Subaru.
Harikari Tsunami, Kamikaze Banzai.
Yamaha, Nikon, Casio, Aiwa.
Yo!
Nota, Hitachi, Seiko, Toshiba,
Buddha, Shiitake Kimono,
Tempura, Sushi,
Sashimi!
Sashimi!
You gotta make your own kind of music. Sing your own special song.
Even if nobody else sings along, chat, do your own thing. Even if nobody else sings along, man. You gotta...